Good morning, our viewers. My name is Evelyn Wajiru Washira. I'm a Kenyan citizen, a teacher by profession, and a mother. This morning, here at the R.O.Y.S, we want to bring you a message. This morning, as I was praying, God put this message in my heart, and I felt it's good to share it here. And God impressed in my heart that we have four things we need to do at a time like this when we are just about to go for our elections. Number one, we need to pray, which we have done. Number two, we need to listen to our candidates and also read their manifestos. And number three, we need to go out and vote. And number four, we leave the final say to God. I want to speak to our young people out there. The students, you are closing school and you will be home for this week. I want to appeal to you, if you're not voting, which most of you in high school you are not, remain at home. It will be safe for you. Don't be found in political rallies or in places where you can endanger yourself. Just sit home, read, and wait, and also pray. Those young people who have got IDs, I'm here to appeal to you. Go out and vote when 9th of August comes. I've met with some of you, we have talked, and you're telling me, I'll not vote. My vote does not count. I want to tell you that your vote counts. And so I encourage you, go out and vote. We have changed this nation through voting, by unvoting the right candidates. And therefore, let us all meet at our polling station. Young people, you are so many, and we appeal to you to go and vote. To our parents and our churches, we are encouraging our children to go and vote. And I've heard in many churches, they are being told, come out, go and vote. And that is very good. It is also important to tell them, why do we want you to go and vote? Because most young people, they'll ask the question, kwa nini niende ni vote? It's only one vote. So it's important to tell them to vote. If you remember what God told the children of Israel in the book of Deuteronomy 6 and verse 6 to 9, he told them, the Bible says, love the Lord God with all your heart. 6 continues saying, and these words which I command you today shall be in your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children, and you shall talk of them when you sit in your houses, when you walk on your way, when you lie down, when you rise up. You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and shall be as frontlets between your eyes, on your doorposts, on your gates. Write them. What was God trying to tell these parents? That whatever you have seen me do for you, whatever commandments I have given you, tell them to your children. Stress it. Talk to them. Don't say once. Always let it be like a story. And therefore, as parents, especially in the season we are in, let us talk to our children. Tell them what God has done for us in this nation. Number one, Let them know of the history of this nation when you have entered an election. If we can remember the time you started voting and what you went through, tell them what has happened. Personally, I can relate or remember as far as 1992, when we voted and then our nation entered into violence, that is tribal clashes. And it was only through prayer, and God intervened in his own way, that we were able to come back and we had a government. We came to 1992. We voted again and we had tribal clashes. Some people's home were burnt. Others were chased away from where they were born. And we had a very tough time in this nation. And It is only through by God's mercy that we again, God brought us back as a nation and we moved on under one government. Then we came to 2002, where now Kenyans were tired of what was happening, and God in his own way helped us to come out, and Kenyans voted. Almost 80% of Kenyans voted, and that is the time we had a turnaround in this nation. We had a peaceful transition, and that year I remember, it is the time the candidate that lost, he bowed and conceded quietly, and we had a peaceful transition. Let our children know this history. Then we came to 2007, when now the candidate who lost, I'm talking about the presidency, he refused to concede, and there was trouble in his nation. It was international, and even the international community had to intervene, and then we had the coalition government. Came 2013, we also had some problems, and as we were transiting, again, it was not very smooth. What do I really want to say? 2013 and 2017, most of the youth we are having now, you were born, you saw what happened. And that is the government we are having today. We have entered now a transition season, and we need to vote. We need to speak out through our vote so that we are able to transit well. I thank the media, and especially the NTV. I've seen them highlight our Kenya history of our Kenyan politics. That is what our young people need, so that they can know it is very important to vote and vote well. And young people out there, listen to the advice that you are being given. When we tell them as parents and our church, it is the only way we shall be able to entrench in them that it is their responsibility to pray and to mold and to vote and make this nation into what they want, and not just to sit and take it as it is a responsibility of others. And now I come to our candidates. My appeal to all the candidates, as a citizen, as a voter, and as a parent, is you have campaigned, we have listened to you, we have read your manifestos, and come 9th of August, we shall go out and vote. We shall go out and vote. Kenyans will vote. Results will be announced. Those who will win, I want you to know that God will entrust Kenya to you. You are just but a steward. It is a nation that God loves. Drive it in the fear of God. God expects you to drive it forward in all fronts as the Lord desires. Just know you are a steward, and one day you give an account. To those who will not make it this time, those who will lose, it is my appeal that you are going to concede early. And this will give room to peaceful transition. And as it happened to our current president, in 2002, I remember, he conceded early. He didn't get it that time. And we had peace. And 10 years later, God fulfilled the desire of his heart. In 2013, yes, he became the president or the fourth president of the Republic of Kenya. So when you'll do Kenyans favor, when you concede early and wait for God to give us the final say. To Kenyans, my appeal is, after voting, let us continue to pray for God's will to happen. We wait patiently, and when the announcements will be made, we embrace the leaders that God will give us. We pray for them, and we help them where we can to drive our nation forward. We leave the final say to God, because he has the final word. God bless you.